Hello, good morning. I'm here again to talk to you on two of our major topics. I'm addressing year 8 class now. Two of our major topics that we did in the past term. Of course, we are doing review now, and we know that even as you're at home, you are studying. I encourage you to continue to keep safe. That's why we have to meet again, keeping safe and keeping distance. All right, so the first topic we'll be looking at is the major parts of a plant. Even this topic, you started doing it from year 7. We talked about major parts, and in year 8 again, we came across it. So, for you to know how important the topic is. So, when we say major parts of a plant, we are referring to just four of parts plant or plant's parts. We're looking at the flower, we're looking at the leaf, we're looking at the stem, and we're looking at the roots. Each of these parts makes up a plant. Because of their functions or what they do. Even men seeing a plant, go out, even look through your window now if you have a plant outside the house. You will see that the parts I have mentioned now, you can easily identify them, except for the root, which is below the ground. Don't forget what you learned about system of a plant, that a plant has two systems, the root system and the shoot system. The root system is the part that is below the ground, why the shoot system is the part that is above the ground. So if you have a plant, for instance, you just draw a line to the base where you have the part where the plant is standing out. Just draw a line across to differentiate the root and the shoot system. So of the four parts, one of it is below the ground and three others are above the ground. So the three others, the ones above the ground, is the one termed the shoot system, which is the stem, the leaf, and the flower. Then you have the root below the ground. We did the different functions of these four parts. Different functions of these four parts. We talked about the flower, which we said bears the reproductive organ. That's the second major topic we'll be looking at. So we'll leave it out for now. So we talked about the leaf. We all know what the leaf of a plant does. If you don't know or you have forgotten, I will still remind you. The leaf of the plant is the part that enables the plant to produce food. All of us, non-photosynthetic plants, all animals depend on plants for food. So the thing that enables the plant to carry out this great function is the leaf that is present in it. It enables the plant to do photosynthesis. And how is this done? It traps energy from sunlight. That is the source of plants. It traps energy from sunlight. The leaf gets energized and splits water into two parts, hydrogen and oxygen. And then the process continues. So what happens? Plants can only be able to carry out, the leaf can only be able to carry out this photosynthesis in the presence of what? Carbon dioxide and water. Where these two materials are present, the leaf is able to produce food. At the end of the process, what they produce is what? Glucose and oxygen is given out as a byproduct. So that is why we are able to get food to eat today. All food that is done, that man feeds on, is gotten from plants. Be it cereal, be it grains, be it vegetables, whatever, we get it from plants. And this is made possible because of the presence of leaf. Green leaves, not just all leaves, but green leaves. And so it's only green plants that do photosynthesis. There are purple leaves. There are any plant that is not green, they are termed non-photosynthetic plants. So another part of plant is the stem. Of course, it transports water that the root brings. The root transports, it absorbs water and minerals from the soil, and then the stem takes it up to other parts of the plant. I will now be looking at the second major topic, which is the flower, the reproductive parts of a flower. So this reproductive part of the flower, that was why I said I'll leave it out when I was looking at the major parts of a plant. The reproductive part of a flower consists of four main parts. A flower consists of four main parts. And it is the flower in a plant that enables reproduction to occur. Plants, yes, plants also do reproduction. So we have four parts. We have the corolla, we have the petals, we have the sep. So we have the corolla, we have the calyx, we have the androsium, and we have the gynosium. These are all the scientific names of the four parts. We have the corolla, we have the calyx, we have the androsium, and we have the gynosium. In class, I remember giving you both names in case, because you never can tell in which form it will appear in your question, in your checkpoint question paper. So I gave you corolla or petal. I gave you calyx or sepa. I told you androsium or stamen, and then gynosium or carpel. So these are the names of the reproductive part of a flower. It contains both the male and the female parts in them, which enables pollination to occur. And what is pollination? It is the transfer of pollen grains from the anther of a flower to the stigma of either the same flower or of another flower. So we'll be rounding it up in the assignment session. Thank you.